a very welcome to you all and good morning. First of all, let me thank the organizers for inviting me here today. I was a bit surprised by the invitation, but definitely pleased. The closest I can think of myself to the tourism industry relates to the fact that I worked for on issues relating to WTO, which happens to be the World Trade Organization, and which carries the same abbreviation as the World Tourism Organization. Incidentally, I was once seated next to a certain person a couple of years back in Korea on the World Economic Forum, and I asked him, what do you do? He was from China, and he said, I am the managing director of WTO. I said, I didn't know my good friend Pascal Lamy has lost his job. I saw him the other week, he was still the director general of WTO. And he said, no, I am director general of World Toilet Organization. So, you know, all these things can create a lot of confusion, and my presence here may also confuse you a bit on that. Now, what brings me here, now that I'm here, let me put my whatever skills I have into use. If you look at the history of economic development in the current age, you will find that tourism is one of the most important driving forces of structural change in most of the developing countries, not to say as one of the most important sectors globally. It is one of the major players in economic activities, in trade, in business, in finance, and tourism or tourist industry surpasses even export turnover in oil. It surpasses even the many other food products or automobile industry. So we quite often do not fully appreciate the level of activity which the tourism really plays in the global economy. It is much more than oil export, it is much more than food exports, it is much more than your purchase of Ferrari and Mercedes-Benz. So let's have that in mind. If you look at the figures as we go around, you will see global GDP at this moment owes almost 9 to 10% of it to tourism. So 10% of the world's income is now currently generated, and profit is generated in the world's tourism sector. And if you see the, if you look at the employment part, and it will at 8.2%, more than 8% of the global employment is now in the tourism sector. And obviously, the projection is that every 12th person in the world will be involved in the tourism sector. Every 12th person in the world will be in the tourism sector in the current decade. And if you look at the exports and the other receipts, it crosses more than $920 billion we are talking about in industry. And if you see that the growth prospect and the investment is also more than 9% of the global investment is now going to the tourism sector. And if you look at the growth prospect, although the global financial crisis of 2008 and afterwards made a serious dent on the tourism industry, the security and safety situations also made an impact on the tourism industry. The tsunami and the other issues also, an earthquake also made an impact on the tourism industry. Nonetheless, in this current year, it is supposed to grow by 6% globally. So it has rebounded back very fast, notwithstanding the global turmoils and the problems in the global economy. Now, the very difficult question which is before us is this 10% of the global wealth is there, so much of employment is there, so much of money and investment taking place. What is the share of Bangladesh in that incremental possibility? That is the critical question which is all there before us at this moment. Now, if you look at these issues as we go, you will see that in many of these countries, the forms of tourism and the structural transformation which has taken place, which are now creating new challenges for the traditional tourism industry and the emergence of the new tourism industry. We know very well that the tourism industry or the forms of tourism is undergoing significant change. The forms of tourism, as you remember, that the way we all say, historically the major forms of tourism has been the It transformed into various kinds of other forms. It went to the natural tourism along with the ecotourism, the ecologically safe things and other things. It moved into other new forms of tourism. You see the medical and the health tourism coming in. And along with that has come in even space tourism. You know, you see the wide range of continuum of different forms of tourism which is unfolding globally. The question is, where does Bangladesh pitch itself? We have just heard that the heritage and the cultural tourism is possibly one of the best possible areas. But if you look at the literature now which is coming in, the critical question is, the most high-value area and the most possible area which has the most prospect, it is now called sustainable tourism. Bangladesh has to pitch itself for sustainable tourism. What is sustainable tourism? I think this is what we are now all discussing. Sustainable tourism is when you do promote your tourism, you create income, you create a flow of investment, but you do not reduce the quality of the nature and also your society and culture at the same time. So you preserve that and you do an incremental thing on those bases. The sustainable tourism, I thought, is very much linked to the Millennium Development Goals. The first goal is eradication of poverty. So sustainable tourism will mean linking the poor people, the informal sector, into the private sector, mainstream tourism industries in many ways. So poverty alleviation and tourism should go hand in hand. This would be the first principle of sustainable tourism. The second point which we will see is that how do you relate the natural issues or the preservation of natural capitals, what we have, whether it is Sundarban or it is the Cox's Bazar Beach or for that matter any other roadside arable land on our road. So how do you link the environmental concerns with the tourism? That would be the second pillar in many ways. The third pillar, if you want to say, it will also be the MDG goal of 7, that is gender equity. How do you really bring in women employment, also linking to the tourism industry? And finally, last but not the least, it is about MDG 8, that is about the international partnership. So you also look forward to international collaboration, international investment, both in the infrastructure as well as in the forms of tourism. So I see the prospect that this is the sustainable tourism is the way out, and that is where all the island states of Pacific or the Caribbeans and all they are redoing themselves. Now the issue is, how does the Bangladesh situation currently looks like? And since we all want to have a good share of this growing industry in the global arena, well, this is an issue if you look at, just to throw in a couple of numbers. You remember the global figures are in the range of 10 and above, as you will see, in terms of GDP, investment, employment, and otherwise. How does Bangladesh figures compare in that way? If the recent figures will show the share of GDP from tourism is around 2.3%, only 2.3%. Even if you broaden the sector and bring in the ancillary activities and auxiliary activities, it doesn't go beyond 6%. So 2 to 2.3% and a broader definition will give us a 6.3%. And if you look at the employment size, the direct employment size as it stands is 15 lakhs, 150,000 people. If you broaden the definition with the associations and others, the indirect workers, it would be around 32 lakhs, 320,000 people. And in terms of employment, it is only still, within the broader employment, is 4%. So you see, we are talking about a global range of 9 to 10%, and we are in the range of 4%. So you see the opportunity to go from this 4% to 10% of the incremental employment as we move in the strategic line. And the growth, the receipts, the income, what we do at this moment, is less than 0.5% of our total exports. So in certain countries, there are 170-180% dependence on export, the tourist arrival income. What we call in our WTO parlance is that consumption abroad, that the mode one. We always fight for mode four. This is the mode one, that when the people come to your country and consume your services. So this is how we want to see it. But the growth prospect is there. 6% growth, 6.2% growth is being projected for this year. That's a great development trajectory which is totally untapped and yet to be really acted upon. The acted upon is in terms of both on the hardware and on the software. The hardware is of course the infrastructure. The infrastructure, whether it is the transport, communication, or lodging, hotels and services and etc. But the software is no less important. The software comes with the image we project of this country abroad. I think that is where the software comes in, how we reach out to the people abroad and what type of projection of this country or what, how people associate Bangladesh with what do they associate with. Would they associate it with floods or famine, or they will associate with our great the success in food production or export promotion or our military in the peace service globally. So it is all depends what image we will try to bring in. I feel, a person who goes around the world, that we are in a transition. The image of this country globally is changing. Issue is whether we will be able to sustain that positive change in the coming years, in the coming months. I leave you with a more, I think, with an optimistic, at an optimistic note. You must, those who travel, and you have seen many ways, the Lonely Planet books. They produce books on each country for the travelers. It's a BBC associated publication. Lonely Planet last year, you might be knowing now, that rated Bangladesh as one of the, they called it, best value destination. You know, putting Bangladesh as a best value destination. And look at the numbers, 181 countries, Bangladesh stands there in absolute size number 72, in 180 countries, 181 countries. Bangladesh is in number 72. In relative size, 151, almost towards the low. But the growth prospect, it is on the 25th position. You see, notwithstanding being low, the growth prospect is high, and the Lonely Planet has picked it up. When they say that it is the best value destination, they don't mean it is the cheapest destination. They essentially mean it's a good return for your money as you come. So I would like to end by saying that we need to also make a distinction, and I was essentially, I will finish here with this number that I was sitting with them. Filipino ambassador, and we were having a small seminar there and discussing what is the inward numbers and the outward numbers. Now, this is the minister may tell us. I tried to locate with my research assistant what is how many people are coming to Bangladesh and how many people are going out from Bangladesh. Now, the Port Chetan Corporation number, please correct me if I'm not wrong, it is giving outbound number is 4,83,074. Inbound number coming in 1,22,000, 23,000. But I look at another World Bank figure. It shows it's almost, outbound figure is almost 9 lakhs instead of 5 lakhs. And the inbound numbers are around 5 lakhs. So inbound there is 8 lakhs, outbound numbers, 9 lakhs, and inbound numbers are 4 lakhs something. So you see, if you have confusion about the numbers, that is also very difficult to do. So I request the minister taking advantage of his presence, please do a strategic plan so we have a long-term vision on this thing and link up the current realities with the future prospect. I see tourism as one of the major structural change, game changer in Bangladesh economy in the coming years. Thank you very much for inviting me.
Thank you, Dr. Gabriel. That was a very detailed insight and the in-depth analysis of the financial, economic growth and the opportunities of Bangladesh has been really, really great. And above all, I guess we would all believe here that the sustainable tourism you have mentioned is definitely, definitely an opportunity for Bangladesh.